Imagine having a dream to be an astronaut, but you live in a country that does not have a space program. That was Soyeon Yi, a bright and talented girl growing up in South Korea. But life, with a twist of fate, intervened, and Soyeon's journey began.
But one day, Korean government announced to the whole public, we will make at least one astronaut, and then we will start astronaut program. And then thinking about my childhood time, and oh my God, that was my dream. And they said, if you are older than 19 years old, and if you believe you have a really healthy body, anybody can apply it. I was sure that I cannot make it because there was a 36,000 candidate. Yeah. It was almost like an American Idol program because it was televised, the whole process of that. Yeah.
That announcement reawakened a childhood dream that was once deemed impossible and gave way to scientific studies. That pursuit of science was just the ticket Soyeon needed to race to the top of the 36,000 applicants.
They want to make a scientist astronaut. So among a lot of people, maybe less than 30% background is engineering or science. So I could have those kind of stuff. So maybe I'm kind of strong in that field. And I was even surprised how healthy I am. And whole 10-month, 6-month process, they keep checking medical stuff, healthy stuff.
A science background and better than good health were joined by a third qualification.
They should be a really good communicator because they should meet whole publics, should have a lot of the public lecture. And then when I was in space, I should have a television program, some kind of education teaching class about science. So they checked some communication skill. But comparing with the other engineers and scientists, I'm quite kind of enjoying to talking with people and then presenting my ideas. So that was also helped me a lot. So it was not one thing, but so many stuff helped me to be go up and again and again.
After all the tests and competitions were complete, Soyeon and Kosan were chosen to go to Russia for a year of training and preparation. Soyeon got the final nod after Kosan violated training center rules. At first, spaceflight wasn't as awesome as other astronauts said it would be. Liftoff brought motion sickness, headache, and back pain.
After for a while, all the motion sickness is gone, and all the painful stuff is over because I adapted as time goes by. Finally, I can fly freely wherever I go, and then I could look through the window without any motion sickness. Not only psychologically, but also physically, you cannot feel that free in anywhere on the ground because no gravity pulls you. So you can fly.
So why Russia and not NASA for South Korea's venture into space?
Americans and then NASA and an American country, they found always a partner and then who can do some project longer than 10 years. So if Korea want to make an astronaut with America, we should be a partnership country of the ISS all the way first. Mm-hmm. And then we should support ISS program, shuttle program, more than several years. In Korea, of course, we are quite an advanced country and we have a lot of money, but we cannot afford to make a certain amount of the budget to keep put the money in that long period of the program. We always have a 2-3 years program was quite longest. But finally, we realized that Russian country sold only one seat for certain 2 years or 1 year. So they just got a small amount of cash to make one person to fly. Even they accepted space tourist, not a country's representative. So we got an idea that maybe our budget plan could be more better fit for the Russian program. And we talked with the Russia. We don't have still astronaut program anymore. There was only one time short-term project. And then why you guys try to make an astronaut? And then they said astronaut is a great asset for being ambassador between space program and public. So serious face, rocket scientists on the TV, nobody listened to them more than 10 minutes. But astronaut who is in a flight suit and then talking about life in space, and all the kids focus on even longer than ours. So they wanna make the ambassador. And then we still have a rocket program. We had a really, really active satellite program because Korea is a really powerful country about IT and communication stuff. So they wanna keep doing that project. They need support from the taxpayer. They need support from the public. And then to make a bridge between two fields, they needed somebody who connect each other. So finally they realized that, we need an astronaut. And then so many other not that high developed space country, they always have an astronaut to be a bridge between two fields.
Celebrity status was inevitable. Soyeon was the first and only astronaut, and everyone in South Korea watched and followed her progress as she conducted 18 carefully chosen experiments. It's a common tale. Celebrity is a mixed blessing.
It was really, really exciting. Whenever I went out of my dormitory, everybody recognized me. And whenever I go to grocery or someplace, and then all the people would call me, "Oh, astronaut, Dr. Yi, and nice to meet you. And then can I take a photo with you? And then can I get an autograph from you?" And then for a certain time, it was quite fun, and all my friends are excited. Oh, my friends is celebrity, and then my mom and dad is so proud of me, and then my brother and sister, and then super excited. Yeah, my sister is an astronaut. But after for a while, it's really hard. More than enough, and then much more than I expect. No more enjoyable. And then all my privacy was exposed, and then I cannot have any personal life at all. I don't want to be a celebrity. I just want to be an astronaut. And then I don't want to be a really famous person. I just want to be a person who go to the space and then do some experiment. So I realized, oh my God, how stupid I am. I just thought like being an astronaut is quite cool, but I couldn't think of consequence of the being the first Korean astronaut. My sister told me, "You applied for an astronaut, but I don't apply for an astronaut's sister. Why should I be so uncomfortable?" And then, that makes sense. Yeah, that makes sense. So it was quite hard. But still, I strongly believe I'm blessed, and I strongly believe I'm quite lucky because only one out of the whole Korean citizens, I'm the only person who will be in space and then who became an astronaut. And, you know, always, great power comes with a great responsibility, as Spider-Man said. So I'm trying to think like that. Yeah. You cannot take always good thing. Whenever you take a good thing, you should think of some uncomfortable things with that. And it's quite fair. And then I think it's quite fair kind of price to pay.
Soyeon uses her celebrity to further her role as a scientific ambassador. She participates in seminars and presentations and teaches kids about space, science, and technology.
But still, I feel huge responsibility to contribute science and technology over the whole world and then to inspire next generation any place in the world. And then that is still the same. Right after becoming an astronaut, I realized that that is my whole-time job and then forever job. And then inspire next generation, talking about science and technology, and then support some other science and technicians as a person who in the middle of the public and then science field. But I don't have to be in space agency as a celebrity forever. Those kind of jobs I can do wherever I am and whatever I do.
Soyeon's space flight was a life-changing experience. As she watched the Earth and her small country roll past the window, she thought about the life below and her place in it.
Finally, I realized that I'm blessed. And anybody who watched this program and TV, we were really blessed because it means we have TV. It means we have systems. It means we have technology. It means we have electricity. But more than 30% of the people, they don't have electricity, stable electricity. My flight changed my life in that part a lot. So I told my students, once you have something to complain, it means you have something. Yeah. The person who cannot have internet at all, they cannot complain about internet because they don't have one. So that changed my attitude of life a lot. And I keep reminding myself, still now, you should appreciate whatever you have.
Soyeon and her husband live in Puyallup. You can watch this program again and share it with friends anytime on our website, PierceCountyTV.org. And you can download our mobile app for smartphones and now optimized for tablets. Thank you for joining us for Pierce County Talks.